Hey guys, so today is what, Wednesday morning. It's been 24 hours since I painted that and did all the stuff. I just threw it out here on top of this because it rained yesterday, so I don't expect this to be all rusty yet, but we'll see what happens. Alright, well, so it's rusty. So obviously, it's already starting to surface rust. So there you go. Now, hopefully that's focusing in. It looks like the area that has the weld through is still protected. The area that burned the weld through off is starting to surface rust. So, and then this is just the epoxy. It's doing about the same thing. Now, this is the other piece that I did that sandwiched. And clearly, we're not going to know what's on the inside of that until I pull that apart. But I should probably leave this out for a while longer just to get the best test possible on this. So I did a little bit more homework, a little more research, and talking to some people and on and on. This weld-through primer is specifically made for this. This is what it's made for. Okay, this is not what it's made for. So if this is the inside of a panel like we talked about, this is not what you want to do. This obviously would not work at all. So if you're going to have inside of a panel like this and you're going to weld through it, it needs to be sandwiched in between another panel like this one. This stuff is very, I mean, you can scratch it off. It's not like epoxy. So you're going to have to protect your welds from the inside by running a wand or some sort of something in there. Another thing that I saw is people are doing, which I thought was a good idea, and these seams, once you're finished doing all your stuff and your car's done or whatever, you either take cavity wax and spray down in here, or you take epoxy primer and let it run down in these seams to kind of flow down around your welds. So if this is, let's say your wheel well, you're going to seam seal this. It's going to have a big old glob of seam sealer across it, so you're protected there. This pot side is going to be inside your trunk, and it's never going to really see any moisture at all, so you shouldn't have to worry about that. So that should all be good. This idea for me about cutting my inside panel and trying to paint on each side and then welding from the outside and having this be left, clearly is not a good idea, because it's, as soon as it gets wet, that's going to happen. What's going to happen 2 years from now, 6 months from now, however aggressive this rust is, it's going to start bubbling right through the back side of this and come right on through my paint, and I'm going to have a bunch of freaking bubbles a couple years down the road. So for me at this point, unless somebody else knows a better way, the absolute best way, if you're going to patch pieces in, for me, is to come in with some internal frame coating, cavity wax, epoxy, whatever you can get to cover the back side of this weld as soon as you're done welding it, to protect it. But yeah, that test will be a fail for me straight off the bat. This is the U-Pole weld through primer. I was hoping that you can see here it says copper. I was really hoping that it was like 24 karat gold, maybe even, you know, 10 karat gold, I don't know, because this can cost me $43. Now, I could order this off eBay and it cost me $35, but I got it here locally for $43. And I thought, since my panels are here, I'm probably gonna need it. And this is the stuff that I'm probably gonna use, because I've heard nothing but good about this copper weld through primer. And it's made by U-Pole. You can get SEM, but I heard it just doesn't work as well. And of course, that's just opinion, but this stuff is very expensive. I hope this can does that whole damn car. So I thought this was a little interesting. I went ahead and pulled the spoiler off. And it's interesting how they did the stripes on this. Came down and they knew they were going to have a spoiler on it, so they didn't finish them out. Just kind of cut them off. That may have been normal for that, but looks like I got a little something going on here. Just noticed it's either Bondo cracking out or Huh. Let me take a look at that. Look like a kind of a rust bubble or something there. I have my glasses on, but looks like Bondo, maybe. Just a guess. Yep, here goes a piece. I haven't decided if I want to leave the spoiler off this or not. I've always liked... I like them both ways, but I like them without the spoiler. Especially with those monster tires that I'm going to put underneath it. I always thought it looked good to have it just like that. Of course, the front end's going to sit down. It's going to all be a little bit lower than when it's sitting right there. And I think because the gap here looks like it does, I'll probably extend this gap down with some rod and close this gap up to where it's a little more nice. But you can see here, it's real tight here. And then it's huge over here. So I was going to move it over a little bit and kind of see if I could kind of get it squared up. And these are either rust bubbles or where they ran the paint, one or the other. But So anyway, I thought I'd kind of show you that. I got sidetracked. I was actually going to take this off. I got to take the trunk lid off, and then I got to take all the interior or the mats and all that kind of stuff out, because I'm going to do these wheel tubs first. So I haven't really figured out exactly how I'm going to move this car around once I get, unless I make some kind of a jig, which I don't really want to do that. But we'll see. All right, see you guys. All right, quick look at the trunk. With all the stuff out of it, it really looks good. This is all just light surface stuff, literally. No holes. Real happy with that. And clean that up with a wire wheel real quick. Won't be an issue. So, yeah, just thought I'd show you that real quick. So, yeah. Good stuff. That's awesome. The stuff that I've got here looks really good. Looks really nice. These are all the pieces for the quadrilink system. Here's the subframe connector set up. Another one in here, I haven't taken it out. The big box that boxes in your shocks, you can probably see there, goes up inside the trunk there. The arm, mini tubs. Now they've still got several more boxes to send me. They haven't shipped everything. I've got, looks like the box number 2's not in there. My coilovers aren't in there yet. I got a bearing set. I got a rear tow hook kit coming. So you can strap the car down if you're going to put it on a trailer. So there's a few more things coming. But pretty stinking cool. So it's like Christmas here. And they even sent me a free t-shirt. It only cost $5,000 for that t-shirt. Oh wait, no, I mean that's a free t-shirt. They threw that in free. Yeah, right. So, yeah. So I got my trunk off, got the springs, up in here out. I've got to cut this away. I've got to mount a bracket to make this stay where it's supposed to before I cut that away. And then I got to start cutting for the mini tubs and all that kind of stuff. Which, not sure what happened today, because the day's gotten away from me. And I've been on the phone quite a bit with some people. But, yeah, super excited about this. Looks like these are my body mount bushings. Solid bushings. All the hardware. So I'm missing one of those still. I'm sure it's coming in a different box. But they said they were going to have to ship this at different times as they, I don't know if it's as it comes in. Of course, the rear end's got to be special made, so, or cut down to the length that for the mini tubs and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, it's like Christmas here. This thing's covered in some kind of cosmoline type oily stuff, probably so it won't rust, which is fantastic. These come already powder coated, because I thought I was going to have these powder coated. So, and I had actually planned on powder coating them this flat black color, so that works out perfect for me. Because I'm going to have the rest of it probably powder coated black, or I will probably epoxy prime a lot of that stuff over there, because I have to weld it, so it wouldn't do me any good to powder coat it and then have to grind the powder coat off to weld it. So I'll probably epoxy this stuff black once I get it all, you know, where it needs to be. Well, it looks like I got all the parts that they sent that I was supposed to have. I called and they're still working on the rear end. The rear end probably won't be here for another two or three weeks. Of course, this will give me plenty to keep me busy with the wheel tubs and everything that's going in. The quarter link system, they've only sent part of it. And so a lot of the other stuff they haven't sent either. So I've still got quite a bit more stuff coming in. Axles and everything else. But I ran into my first problem already. I opened the instructions for the mini tub kit. And the very first thing it says is, all work should be performed by a qualified welder and technician. I don't know anyone like that. I know I'm not qualified, and I'm not, especially not a technician. So I guess we're going to wing it like I do everything else. Hope it goes together. I was thinking, you know, since they did what they did here on the car with the pop rivets, that I've got a pretty nice little pop rivet set in there that I could probably pop rivet all this stuff together. Pop rivet the tubs, and it should work. I mean, in theory, right? They pop rivet airplanes together. Hell, look what kind of shear pressure and shit they go through. So surely work on a car, right? So anyway, I don't know, maybe if I put this shirt on, maybe that will make me a qualified technician. I bet that will probably do it. Because then I'll look professional. So nobody will know, at least, that I'm not a qualified technician. So, yeah, we'll try that. There's the picture of the Quadralink set up. Looks like I got one of these bars. I didn't get two of them. I only got the one. I got the other ones coming. I got the full subframe connector kit, and then I got the full mini tub kit. So we're getting pretty close there. So yeah. A little bit more work to do pulling the stuff out from underneath the car, and we'll get on this in the next day or two, unless something else comes up that I need to do before I get into that, which I really don't know. Anything else I need to do? There's no reason to need to brace anything because I'm not really cutting anything out other than those brackets that go over the wheel tubs. And I will have to brace those up. It looks like it shows that straight off the bat. So it's got like a little bar they run off here and just tacked onto that to keep it in place. It's called a decklidge hinge brace. So anyway. Alright guys. Well, talk to you later. Alright guys, I got a little sidetracked here, but I found something I'm not real happy with. You guys will tell me what you think on this. I was thinking about making a body dolly, basically, so I can roll this thing around when and I don't have to tie up the lift here. So I was looking for points underneath here to basically go to, and I thought, you know, I could go probably right in here to one of these main, you know, holes here in the frame. And then obviously these up here are where you kind of want to go to there with the subframe off. But here's what I run into. I got to looking underneath here. As you see the frame coming up, you got a bulge right there. And then you got an indention under here. And I just thought, oh no, this car's been ass-ended at some point and it's bent the frame rails. So I went over here to double check. This one is back here and it's bent up in there, bulged out a little bit there, and then bulged out right here on the outside. So my guess is the car got hit back here and it obviously pushed the ass end down like that, which changes the game a lot for me. It's got me doing some more thinking. And man, this thing is so clean underneath. That's the deal. I mean, I could probably put this on some kind of frame machine and try to somehow pull those back out and beat those back together to get it back right. But I know you can buy these fairly cheap and replace them. But did it flex everything else down, you know what I mean, on the car? And this is, and that's sticking out eighth of an inch or so from the sides. And it's bulged out on both sides. It literally had to have, something had to hit the ass end just enough to drop it just a little bit. And you know, I don't know what all that's done back under here. It's just hard to say how much that bent that down. And if it bent that down, did it also bend the floor pan and the truck pan, you know, down? I don't see anything up in there that looks like it's bent wrong, but that right there definitely bothers me, and this here. It's not severe, obviously, but and it looks like, best I can tell, it probably cracked that area there, you know, from it pushing in. So I don't know. It'll change a lot of stuff, and I don't want to start putting this mini tub kit in and everything because I got to cut into these rails. And if they're bent, that's going to throw some other things off, and it could throw the rockers off, and who knows what all. So, yeah, I'm a little, you know, I'm just kind of figuring this out just now, but, that sucks. Ow. There's a rear end right there. Oh, son of a bitch. That hurt. So yeah, don't really know. Dang, man, that sucks. Well,
Yeah, you guys tell me what you think. I'm kind of looking at other things now, thinking, did something else get pushed in? You know, is that gap supposed to be there? You know, did it push it and cause the ass end to push this out? There's not a gap on this side like there is on that side. So, yeah. Anyway, you guys, if you don't mind, maybe when you guys look at your car, you know, you can just look around the tire here maybe and see if, I'm almost positive that's what's happened. That's not supposed to be that way. There's no way. But obviously at some point in this thing's life, it got popped pretty good in the back end, or good enough to where it bent the frame rails. Of course, those are obviously not super high, you know, strength steel, but still, I wasn't planning on changing the frame rails out on this bad boy. But that'll change my whole dolly plan if I have to do that, because I'll have to make a body jig for it. And take the whole floorboard out. Basically cut this car into pieces. Goodness gracious. Anyway, so yeah, let me know what you guys think about that. Like I said, that threw me off there pretty good. So I'm gonna have to think about what I'm gonna do now before I continue to disassemble all this. So I'll holler at you guys later.